fuck is hot.
Here we are, Dale. Fairfax Avenue.
Whoa.
The fuck is hot.
I'm Dale.
What up, Dale?
That outfit is normcore as hell.
Yeah. You look like if Tom Hanks f***ed to REI.
True.
You literally just named two of my favorite things. Just moved here from Oregon with my family. Can I get a whoop whoop?
Don't do that.
I'm coming in fast.
What's everyone waiting for?
Latrine's Thursday drop.
Totally. What's a drop?
The f*** you just say?
Did my little baby make friends?
Best friends.
So there's this kid, Benny. He's a hype beast.
This place is a fashion goldmine.
And this girl, Derica, she could legit be president.
Stop milking almonds.
And there's Truman. He's super artsy.
Fire.
When do you turn 18?
I'm 13, Miss B. Don't make me cancel you.
Rick Hong here for Hollywood First Look. Today, I am with Jaboukie Young-White, Peter Kim, Kiersey Clemons, and Skyler Gisondo, and we are talking their show, Fairfax. So, gentlemen, I like this show so much. Obviously, you can see, you know, like I'm hanging out by Schwimmers, and I'm also channeling my inner Benny Choi. I've got the glasses and the sweatshirt.
Yeah,
I'm a poser. I didn't want to stand in line, so I don't actually have like the train on here, but... So I'm wondering, like, were you already kind of familiar with like a sneakerhead hype beast culture? Because I live right near Fairfax. So like, I see it all the time. I got educated through the show.
It was something that I had been like when I was younger, I was obsessed with, like followed so digital. I would spend hours on Nike ID, like making my own colorways on shoes and stuff. Like I was super into it. And then once I came to terms with the fact that I could not afford it, I was like, actually, I think the thrift store is more so my thing. So I'm just going to like, I'm going to lean into that aesthetic. But it's something that I always like kept up with. So it was kind of like rekindling like a long lost love with like being a hypebeast and like hypebeast culture and stuff like that.
I knew nothing about it. I grew up like a little church kid, a fat church kid that was like closeted and playing D&D. I had one pair. I own one pair of sneakers at a time. Like I make it run out and there's holes in it until it. So definitely learned a lot through the show. And, but it was cool to play like a Korean kid leading a show that you never see that, you know, Rick, you know, like there's never a Korean lead, especially one that's like super braggadocious and confident and cool. So I thought it was a really cool character to play.
I'm Dale. I had a superficial awareness of it, but like so not cool and so didn't really know, you know, the ins and outs of it. So it was an educational experience. I was kind of learning as Dale learned, even though I've grown up in LA. I grew up in Manhattan Beach, which feels very, very far away from Fairfax, even though it's only like 30, 40 minutes. So yeah, I, as Dale kind of, you know, got into it, so did I.
I've never been into that world really, but I was really aware of it. I've definitely been in the stores and I think waited in a line with like a boyfriend when I was like 15 or something like that.
How did you like seeing Fairfax get turned into animation?
Dude, it was so cool. I didn't, until I really, I knew obviously it's set so specifically in LA and in the Fairfax district, but until I saw the animation coming together and they showed us some of the stuff, to see like LA brought to life in this way, it's so cool. And all these kind of iconic locations that are present and like all of the delis and like, you know, Cantor's, Swimmer, whatever it is, like, all these things we've kind of grown up around, I've never seen it brought to life like in this way. That was a total trip and really cool.
Oh, I felt the same way. It was the coolest. I don't know. There's something about it that it feels like when you go to like a theme park, it kind of feels like that where I was like, whoa, I feel like I'm there.
Seeing the place you grew up like through fresh eyes too, right? Because you're watching and you're like, damn, this is like, this is what this place is. Like, you know, it's funny and it's like stretched here and there, but like, this is it. And to see it through fresh eyes is really cool.
It was it was really funny being able to catch like the little winks and the nods. That was great. And also just like the character design and just like watching all the, like looking at all the outfits, like it's just so like visually pleasing that it was great. Like it was such a fun watch.
The animated version of Fairfax is where I want to hang out. It seems really cool. And yeah, it just seemed like way, it is very similar in that like they've like recreated like Schwimmers, Cantors, et cetera. They even have Barks and Bitches, I believe. which I go and just hang out with dogs sometimes because my apartment doesn't allow dogs. But yeah, it was really fun to see it being honored and also satirized at the same time.
The show is Fairfax. You can find it streaming on Amazon Prime Video now.
You wanna come party with us?
Crank up the thirst meter!
Turn and burn!
Let's build!
Yeah. No.
That ain't it.
Nobody dabs anymore, Jesus.
Yo, Joaquin, can you help us out?
Been super busy with menu, art, installation.
What's your medium?
I'm gonna light myself on fire.
Whoa.
Love it. So cerebral.